Local governments have huge infrastructure gaps from different sectors like education, health and transport that need to be addressed, and most of the time these have always depended on the central government for these needs. But as time goes by, the finance ministry says they have come to be constrained by budgetary allocations that have made meeting infrastructure development needs difficult.
Yeah, over the years we have been borrowed and we are continuing to borrow. As we borrow, the debt burden keeps building unless you pay off all your debts. But sometimes the capacity to pay off all the debt is not there. So you get a build-up of that debt, which ultimately works into your available discretionary resources. So probably next financial year, we are seeing about 3.5 trillion being deducted from the discretionary resources due to partly debt service.
While local governments have the potential to develop infrastructure through partnerships, many have been left behind.
So one of the biggest challenges that we've had in local governments, like I said, is that developing proposals. You know, developing proposals, concepts that are sellable to the private sector. So we've had that gap. And you know, the PP guidelines support us because they provide a step-by-step process that guides how a project is developed all the way to implementation. So we believe that they try to cover this gap, to fill the gap up, and then local governments can be able to develop projects that are sellable. We understand.
It's against this background that the Finance Ministry has developed new guidelines that will enable local governments to package infrastructure to attract private sector players.
So we're changing the ball game from the point of view of this is what somebody is dangling, give away, to can we partner and work together and change the way we look at these projects. So increasingly, districts should see the value that the private sector is looking for. Don't go for the lease fees, go for what they are looking for. Allow them to do what they are looking for, but with the value coming back to you as well. So it's a revenue sharing arrangement. It can be done anywhere.
The guidelines are expected to awaken the business mindedness among the local government. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.